Let us take the next question. It is given, a solid aluminium shaft 120 mm diameter is to be replaced by a hollow steel shaft having 120 mm outer diameter. The two shafts have same angle of twist per unit torque over the total length. If GS, that is modulus of rigidity for steel, is equal to 3 times of modulus of rigidity for aluminium, find inner diameter of hollow shaft. This is the question which we have, where we are replacing the solid shaft with hollow shaft. Now, I'll write the data this for this question. Solid aluminium shaft is 120 mm in diameter, means if I write the diameter for aluminium, it is 120 mm. Is to be replaced by hollow steel shaft having 120 mm outer diameter. So steel shaft is having outer diameter as 120 mm. If the two shafts have same angle of twist per unit torque, so it is angle of twist per unit torque, means theta is the angle of twist per unit torque. Are same, means theta by T ratio is same for aluminium and it is same for steel, it is given in the question. Over the total length, means length also remains same. So length of aluminium is equal to length of steel. They are saying that modulus of rigidity of steel is 3 times of modulus of rigidity of aluminium. We have to find the inner diameter of hollow shaft. How much would be the inner diameter of hollow shaft? Hollow shaft means it is a shaft of steel. Now, let us try to solve this problem. It is a conceptual kind of a problem. Solution. First, I'll draw the cross section of both the shafts. Here I have solid aluminium shaft. And hollow steel shaft. Solid shaft is having its external diameter capital D. Hollow shaft is also having its external diameter as capital D. Both the values are same in this case, it is 120 given. We have to calculate how much is this inner diameter for hollow shaft. This is the question for us. Now, in this question, first I will calculate the polar moment of inertia separately because this will help me in the question. Here, I'll say that since polar moment of inertia, that is polar MI, is given by, I'll find out J for aluminium, which is solid. The formula of polar moment of inertia for solid shaft is pi by 32 diameter raised to 4. So it is equal to pi by 32, diameter is 120. So therefore I get J aluminium, polar moment of inertia of aluminium. It comes out to be 20.36 into 10 raised to 6 mm raised to 4. Next, I will calculate polar MI for steel, that will be hollow, pi by 32 capital D raised to 4 minus small d raised to 4. This becomes pi by 32, capital D is 120. Small d is what we have to calculate. So here I will keep this as it is because I don't know the value of small d, and that is what we have to calculate. So this is the polar moment of inertia for steel. Now, after finding the polar moment of inertia, I will utilize the condition which they have given. Since T upon theta, angle of twist per unit torque, is same, I can say that we know this relation, that T upon J is equal to g theta by L. So therefore, if I calculate theta by t, that will be equal to L upon gj. So I will use this condition that theta upon t is equal to L upon gj. And since theta by t is equal for aluminium and steel, I'll write down, since angle of twist per unit torque for aluminium is equal to angle of twist per unit torque for steel, therefore L upon gj for aluminium is equal to L upon gj for steel. Therefore, length of aluminium, I'll write it as LA, length of steel is LST. Then G value, it is given that here I have G for aluminium. Its J value we have found out. For aluminium, it is 20.36 into 10 raised to 6. Next, G value for steel, it is mentioned that it is 3 times of the G value for aluminium into J for steel is pi by 32, 120 raised to 4 minus small d raised to 4. Now, since the length of both the shaft, aluminium and steel, they are same, it will get cancelled out. Your G for aluminium and G for aluminium, modulus of rigidity gets cancelled. So overall, if we look here we are left with only small d, which is the unknown. So if I simplify this, I will be getting this as, therefore 120 raised to 4 minus d raised to 4 is equal to 69.122 into 10 raised to 6. That is, I have shifted 120 raised to 4 minus small d raised to 4 on one side. 20.36 10 raised to 6 goes into the numerator, dividing it by pi by 32, I get this answer. So finally, I will subtract, shift d raised to 4 on one side and subtract 69.122 10 raised to 6 from 120 raised to 4. I will be getting the answer of d raised to 4 as, which I have already calculated, 138.23 into 10 raised to 6. Now if I take, I want to calculate the small diameter, so here I have to take the square root twice. So if I take the square root twice, I will be getting the value of small d as 108.43 mm. This is my answer. So if I look into this question, they were telling us to calculate the internal diameter for the hollow shaft, and this internal diameter we have calculated, it is 108.43 mm, and with this we complete the question.